What's up, everybody? This is Mike, the Developing Dad, coming to you with another reflection on the Proverbs. It is April 27th, 2020, and we're going to be in Proverbs 27, verse 19. And it reads, "As in water, face reflects face, so the heart of man reflects the man." Okay, so we've got another simple simile here, and it's set up in such a way that we can easily understand it. As in water, face reflects face. Simply put, just as you can see yourself or who you are physically in the water, or in our case, a mirror, right? Well, back then they didn't have mirrors the way we have many of our mirrors today. But you could look into the water and you could see your face reflecting back and you knew who you were physically. Just as you can do that with water, you can know who you are spiritually, and we can know who we are spiritually by examining our hearts. Our hearts will reflect who we are spiritually. Now, how is that the case? Okay, well, Jesus Christ gives us some very good doctrine on that in Matthew chapter 12, starting at verse 33. It says, "Either make the tree good and its fruit good, or make the tree bad and its fruit bad. For the tree is known by its fruit. You brood of vipers, how can you speak good when you are evil? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. The good person out of his good treasure brings forth good, and the evil person out of his evil treasure brings forth evil. I tell you, on the day of judgment, people will give account for every careless word they speak. For by your words you will be justified, and by your words you will be condemned." And he picks up that same thought in Luke chapter 6. Starting at verse 43, "For no good tree bears bad fruit, nor again does a bad tree bear good fruit. For each tree is known by its own fruit. For figs are not gathered from thorn bushes, nor are grapes picked from a bramble bush. The good person out of the good treasure of his heart produces good, and the evil person out of his evil treasure produces evil. For out of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaks." And then finally, in Matthew chapter 15, Peter asks Jesus a question starting at verse 15. He says, "But Peter said to him, 'Explain the parable to us.' And he said, 'Are you also still without understanding? Do you not see that whatever goes into the mouth passes into the stomach and is expelled? But what comes out of the mouth proceeds from the heart, and this defiles a person. For out of the heart come evil thoughts, murder, adultery, sexual immorality, theft, false witness, slander. These are what defile a person. But to eat with unwashed hands does not defile anyone." So we see here Jesus makes it clean that our words, they come from our heart, and all of our sinful deeds come from our heart. So if our heart is not changed, we will continue to walk in these evil deeds. And this is a good list for us to check out. If we need to know whether or not our hearts are in line with God, if we always thinking evil thoughts, if we're always murderous in our thoughts, adultery, sexual immorality, if we're thieving, if we're bearing false witness, lying, slandering, these we are defiled. All right, we need to come to the Lord in repentance and faith and trust in Jesus Christ so that He may wash away those sins and restore us and make us new creations, giving us a new heart, giving us a heart of flesh, and removing that heart of stone, as Ezekiel tells us in chapter 36, and then Jeremiah in the New Covenant. We also get that in chapter 31, verses 31 through 34, the promise of the New Covenant is a new heart, and the law written on that heart. So we want that. That's what we're looking for as believers, right? We examine ourselves, and we even have, again, what can we do? How can we know these things? Well, the Bible is very clear about the works of the flesh and the works of the devil. And I'll give you an example of that. But what we need to do as believers is to examine ourselves, right? 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 5 says, "Examine yourselves to see whether you are in the faith. Test yourselves, or do you not realize this about yourselves, that Jesus Christ is in you, unless indeed you fail to meet the test." Well, it's clear as day in the scriptures that our job is to examine ourselves to know whether or not we are in the faith. And then one of the tests that we can use, or two tests, I'm going to give you two examples of tests, is to look at the fruit of the Spirit, right? In Galatians chapter 5, starting at verse 22, it says here, "But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things there is no law. And those who belong to Christ have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires." We will have crucified the flesh if we're truly following after Jesus Christ. And these will be the markers. These will be the fruit, that fruit that Jesus was talking about. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. These are the things that will mark our lives. And then again, on the converse, right, in verses 19 at the beginning, verse 19 of chapter 5, "Now the works of the flesh are evident." Paul says they're evident. "Sexual immorality, impurity, sensuality, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, fits of anger, rivalries, dissensions, and divisions. I warned you," and things like these. Oh, I'm sorry. "Drunkenness, orgies," I forgot a couple, "and things like these. I warn you, as I warned you before, that those who do such things will not inherit the kingdom of God." And we want to inherit the kingdom of God, right? All right, so that's what we can do. And then there's also one really a good book that just lays things out for us. First John, it is, if you read through this book daily, you will be confronted with what it means to be a believer. There's so many good things, if then statements. If you don't do this, then you're not a believer. John lays it out as well. So our job, again, is to examine ourselves to make sure that our heart is reflecting God. And then when we look into that mirror of our heart, we're not reflecting the world, but we're reflecting Jesus Christ. All right. So I pray that this blesses you today. And I hope that we can spend some time today examining our hearts. All right. So if you haven't already, please like the video, comment, subscribe, and share it out as much as you can so that this may bless others. And I'll see y'all on the next one. Grace and peace.